Hey, every guy. Every guy. Hey, everybody. Okay. Well, we got this stage complete. All right. Now, I have to... So these are actually the secondary pop tent parts. Now I have to figure out this part. Right? There. So I want those on each side. Those ding things. Which one was the one that worked right? Was this? I thought this was the one that worked. Did I get this one to work? It went out too far. That one was too tall. That one was totally wrong. This one was too tall. Okay. So what I'm going to do is try to make a smaller base. Isn't this the one that worked once I taped it down? It's not tucking all the way in now. Okay. Here we go, guys. Let's find some cardstock. If I can figure out where it is. Have a whole package of it sitting here somewhere. Okay, here it is. I want to try to make it a little bit smaller than this. It doesn't have to be as big now. And I'm actually going to use the bone folder. Board to make an exact it's a tight fitter, isn't it? Oh god, hopefully I didn't just split out the tape. I was hoping to just push the paper. It's huge! I don't like that funky folding that it's doing. But it's okay. We just have enough of a gap here for it to move. So it's okay. I guess all four of them have that gap, huh? I can still take out one more signature if I need to. Alright, do you see what I'm seeing? I need to loosen this tape. I can still do it easily enough, I think. Where's the X-Acto knives now? I see the one. Where's the second one? Where's the sharp one? Okay. So we're just trying to go through the top here. Split it out. Not through the whole thing, preferably, which I just might have done. Actually, I probably didn't want to do that. Now that I've done it, let's pull it up from here. And cut it from here. Okay, come on. Okay. What we're trying to do is give this some space. Beautiful corners that I did. Maybe we can just leave that kind of raggedy though, that'd be fine. And here. Okay. See how that just let go? So, please, 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 please don't get ruined. And I'm just trying to give this a little extra push here to open that up. Okay, that's the tape sticking to the tape. Again, just trying to open it up. See? Without killing what you got. I think we're good. I think we're good there. I can retape that down. Even that is way better. How we're probably going to have to stick those guys up. Oh, there we go. This guy. Does not... Mod Podge does not like to stick to this tape. That is the key here. Key to this lesson. So this is going to have to not get in the way of our flap either. Why are you doing that now? Too much? Much better. Okay, so. Cut. Okay, we got a little split, you know. I cut into that right there. And there. But we'll fix it. We'll fix it. We'll fix it. Be okay. So, you know, I mean, we got to remember we can still, we're still, you know, we're still going to cover these outside things. So, it's okay. We got first aid. Sure, it sits as flat as we can possibly make it. All right. So, leave yourself 3 times more space than what you think you'll need. Right? But, see the difference? Needed to be done. Absolutely necessary. And I do need to stick with tape there. Absolutely. Perfect. So is that enamel paint pen? Take a couple layers. We're actually painting the underside of this table. We'll grunge it, it'll be fine. Just has to lose its sticky a little bit right there. Nice. Okay. Same here. Okay, so this whole page we can get to. I don't want to take it all off though. I think if I just do like I did on this other side, hopefully that'll be fine. Let's see. Cut it along here. Let it escape that corner. Pull it up. Escape this corner. Here. And nope. I am not okay with it. You know, having all that unhappiness to it, you know? So, see, immediately, it flattened. The tension was released and it flattened. And we're back to a semi-normal size book. And there's a lot less bending in there. That's definitely a good thing. Okay. All right, let's pull this back here just a touch more. And this time I didn't split out the stuff in the front. The tape in the front. We're gonna tear this off, maybe? Yes, we are. Perfect. 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 See, it feels still a little tight here, so we gotta make sure that that's loosened. We're really gonna need this space when we put in the fold-outs, you know? I mean, hopefully I can figure out how to make this work like that. It works better like that now. Well, to an extent. I mean, we're looking at a full inch thick down here, inch and a half. Crazy. But we have more space. I wonder if we should pull it off on this side too. I don't think it makes any difference with where it's at here. You know, I worry about bulkiness, of course. I worry about all of those construction issues. This gaffer's tape seems to be pretty friendly. I just hope that it sticks through wear and tear. Wow, that's a perfect size cut, right? Okay, so as much space as I can possibly give that is what we need. So let's see if I can pull it just a touch more here. Pull it this way. Pulling it just a touch up from this. Remember, we'll have a little bit of paper tear. But thank God, you know, I'm using this chipboard. That is really nice, heavy-duty, strong stuff, you know. This paper can take it. Okay. Really trying to get my finger in there. I would take a bone folder, I would take a credit card, whatever you can. All right, I was thinking I was gonna have to do that earlier. I'm glad I didn't do it earlier because I would have needed to readjust it again, right? Adjust, adjust, and readjust. Story of the world, huh? Much nicer, much nicer. Much less stress. See? Still pops out. Still always gonna. I guess if I were to redo it again, I would make these inner flaps shorter. Offset the poles, pulleys. Well, yeah, that's how the pulleys were stacking up. That gives it that most of its stress. Are we still okay? Still okay. Still got it here. Okay. Fresh pop. I kind of like it extending all the way up to there. Okay. That was a whole crazy segue. I was not thinking about that, obviously. All right. I was thinking about this. This project. Oh, I'm tired. Okay. Now, they say that the key, they say that the key to making a good pop-up is to make sure that the folds are as strong as, or as crisp as you can make them. Now, you do not have to have this, of course. You can use a ruler with a pen tip that, you know, the pen is, you know, I've heard that that works. Not the pen being out, the pen being in. I did recently get this because I wanted I'm gonna start making some junk journals, and that's what I was gonna do this weekend, but I got started on this crazy project. I need to actually truly be working on canvases. I have to do that. I want to make some good Christmas presents. I also want to make a couple more altered boxes, cigar boxes. So here, we're just going to pull it along. Making the best fold that I can here. Don't fold it so much that I break the paper. Wouldn't be surprising. Would not be the first time. Okay, did we get this one to work? I don't think we got this one to work. This one I know for sure didn't work. All wrong. This one was almost gonna work. It's almost there. So, when you make it that big, which it would have been so cool to do, but I think that the maximum width I can do is half page to half page. And I think that's why the smaller one worked better. I think this was the one that we were... It's too big. I'm living off of these sparkling waters. I really like them, and they help me to drink a lot more fluids. They say that there's nothing adverse to them. Low mineral content. I enjoy them a lot. I mean, this is a dollar at Trader Joe's here. I like it. Okay. So. Now, another thing, too, is we really need to make sure that these fold when I decide where they're going to be. I keep saying we. Another thing I need to make sure of. Okay. So, these are my main tents, right? And I just want to do a little bit in front of them. As much as I can. Let's try this theory of just going half. So that's going to be 2.5 inches total here. Our tent has to stop at 2.5 inches. Let's try this. I might be finally seeing it, guys. This tag seems to have to go at a 45 degree angle. Is that 45? So I'm going to take that from there. I'm going to do the tag. I can always cut down the tag. So, let's do this. Let's try this angle. Let's try a little flip up here and straight across. I can't remember who mentioned that. Somebody made that observation. One of you lovely people. The bottoms are almost straight across on this one that works. I might be able to bring it down just a little bit here in the center. Let's try this. Do I want one center point? So the thing is that this center point doesn't tuck all the way in. However, I would like to try one like this. I'm going to try it, because now that I've made it skinnier, or half book width, it might work better. Now, things that I will need to adjust probably along the way are going to be angle of the tags. And possibly height of the point. I did it. Oh, guys. Oh. I think I did it. I think I figured it out. I was making them too big. So I can do three of those. Okay. So let's do this real fast. Here. Bone folder. Make it a super sharp. I'm only going to do one side. It's basically almost at a 45 degree angle there. Okay. And we want to make sure this one does the same exact thing. Exact same thing. So we got to push a little bit here. See, I've been thinking about this. I've been thinking and thinking and thinking and thinking about this. See here, if I do this right there to that right there. Okay, so this has to line up with that. That is one thing that they said, is that you have to have your fold line up with the center fold, has to line up. And I don't want, like, gotta go backwards for a second and fix that. So I'm gonna make it pop up just a little bit more. I didn't want a real extreme pop up. I think in order to make it fit, it's going to have to be. I might have to cut down that point a half a touch. And we're just going to do that because I think that'll make it work best. Okay. That should be it. It'll work. Okay. Trying to keep that glue going over this side and not on the inside tract. I got glue all over. God, I always go backwards. Okay. But remember how much stress is being put on that when it's closing, right? And we do know that this chipboard does pull apart relatively easy because we've done it a couple times here. Trying to leave as much space in that envelope as possible. Come on, don't do that. Whatever you're tripping on. That kid dig in. It's right there. It's right in here. That's where it's tripping up. Okay. Whew. Oh. Okay, and then the fold goes from here to here, and from here to here. I still want to see if I can do the banner pop-up. I know, right? I'm insane. I think they did fold them both ways, back and forth. The paper people. The paper people. Yeah, I got them off. It's supposed to go. It's gonna make a difference where that's folded. Oops. That's me. I got to keep them all the same. Finally see it. It's not quite as grandiose as it once was, but it is completely different than anything I've seen out there. Okay, so this video is obviously getting to be long enough, and I probably have to free up some room. Whew. I'm gonna get these guys covered. And they'll probably get a little bit more of the wild honey color. And none of... They might get a squirt of the brick. And none of the blue, hopefully. Okay, guys. I'm going to stop there. Pop-out construction, I think, is figured out. And, I'll bring you back for part 9. Okay? I'm thinking, what type of little latch can I do? What type of thing can I do to keep these in place? Oh, well, I could put the rivet there. Nope, I can't put a rivet there anymore. I could make it look like there's a rivet or a brad there, though, and then it slips under a tab. This is good. Is this fixed? Is this fixed? Yay. Little kids hanging out. Okay, guys. It's almost there. It's almost there. At least the construction is almost there. We're just on construction. We're halfway decorated. There will be more stuff on here as we go along. There will be. Hey, please hit that subscribe button if you already haven't. I love hearing your comments, and they do trigger thoughts. You know, the person who said flat across the bottom. I'm not sure who it was. Sorry about that. But it was a really good, observation. And I think the fact that I was trying to make it too big, once I figured out, I think that you can only really span halfway. You might be able to get more. And there was, I did see another really cool pop-up, but I don't think I can combine the two, and I don't think I have space for the two. Oh my gosh, my brain. Drives me a little crazy. Okay, we'll chat soon. Bye.